Good morning, everyone, and happy Friday, August 19th, 2021. How are you doing this morning or wherever you are? Maybe it's close to afternoon for you. Anyway, I am happy that you're here. My name is Lisa Breezy, exercise physiologist, wellness heart coach, and founder of State of the Heart Fitness. And today's 45-minute class is stretch and relax. Good for all levels. But what I always say, make sure that you listen to your body. If something doesn't feel quite right, modify, adjust, rest, take a breather, have some water. Let's make it fun. All right, so we're going to open up, stretch, and at the end, we're just going to lie in peace and relax and let it all go. Okay, let's get the music started. Let's get the fun started. The smiles on our faces. And we're going to get ourselves moving to get the blood flowing. Yes, wake up the body a little bit. So just start swinging those arms, big swing, side to side, your feet about shoulder width apart. Keep those knees soft. And of course, smiles on those faces, because there's no place we'd rather be than right here, right now. Good. And just get a little exaggerated with those movements. Arc those arms over the head. So our goal here is just to get the heart pumping a little bit more, get the blood flowing, circulation to the tissues, to the cells. Woo! Oxygen, nutrients. Good. Let's take those arms and let's just do some big infinity signs. So get those knees involved. Yes, nice fluid motions. Like a fresh mountain stream through our body. So if you needed a visual, being sedentary is kind of like a monkey swamp in our body. Moving, stretching, opening it up like a fresh, clean, clear mountain stream. Yes. Now let's just go ahead and just take those arms and just imagine doing a backstroke. You're lying on your back through a beautiful Minnesota lake. Yes, Minnesota, my roots, of course. And nothing brings back better memories than being on a placid lake, beautiful morning or evening, and just doing that backstroke. Yes. Hearing some loons in the distance. Oh, yes. But open up those arms. Big circles. So when we are sedentary, when we sit a lot, or when you get up out of bed in the morning, right? You're stiff. Gotta stretch. Our animals, cats and dogs, always stretching. Now let's do the opposite. Let's just do that crawl stroke. Big circles. Get your upper body moving with it. Yes. So the connective tissue, our tendons, our ligaments, our fascia, the myofascias, the cobwebby, sinewy-like connective tissue that lines every little muscle fiber, all of that gets a little rigid when we've been sitting or sleeping for a while. Good, let's shake out those arms. Let's take a deep breath in. Inhale those arms up and reach them up there. Really lengthen, anchor into your feet, into the ground, into the earth. Breathe long and slow. So stretching allows that connective tissue to lengthen, cuts through the sinewy fascia, the cobwebs. Because when that connective tissue gets tight, compromises our posture, makes us at greater risk for injury, greater risk for falling, because we're not as agile. Good. Let's take those feet hip-width apart. Let's reach the arms back. Inhale. And exhale. Fold forward. Inhale. Bring it back up. Reach. Exhale. Bring it down. Inhale. Reach. Good. Exhale. As you come up, bring those arms out wide. Yes, celebrating the day. Forward. Inhale, up, stretch. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, up, stretch. Exhale, fold forward. Good, keep a couple more going here. How we feeling out there, team? Breathing deep and slow. Let's hang out here. Let your head relax. Keep your knees slightly bent. Now let's rotate our arms in the outward direction. Breathe deep and slow. Notice that those arms start to move on their own. Once you get going, let gravity stretch your neck. Feel the stretch in the hamstrings, the back of those legs. And reverse those circles, big circles, inward direction. Excellent job, everybody. Now let's go ahead and take an elbow in each hand. And we're just going to sway side to side, making a little semicircle around your knees. With those arms, feel the stretch in the glutes, the hips, the hamstrings. Our hamstrings, the back of those legs, are often very tight, especially if we sit a lot. And when we have tight hamstrings, it starts to pull on the lower back. Anybody ever have any lower back pain? 80% of you Americans do at some point in their life. And it can just be from tightness. tightness and pulling on that spine. Go ahead, relax. Let your head relax. Arms just dangle. And then slowly start with your tailbone. You're going to stack one vertebra on top of the other. Take your time. Unwind your spine slowly. With your shoulders, your neck, your head, relax. And let's just roll those shoulders up and around in a backward direction. Big circles. Feel those shoulder blades slide up and down our back. Stretching also helps to improve our body awareness. We tune into our body. We feel. Where are we feeling this in our body? Visualizing those shoulder blades sliding up and down your back as you rotate. Let's take a moment to take our hands to our heart. Close your eyes. Just bow your head down for a moment, and I just want you to bring your awareness into your feet. Feel your feet connect with the earth. And as you breathe, as you inhale, I want you to imagine breathing energy from the earth up through your feet, through your legs, all the way up your spine, into your heart. As you exhale, you can let that energy go out through your crown into the universe. Just long, slow, deep breaths here for a moment as we center ourselves and we tune into the heart space. And we feel our connection to the earth, to the heavens, and we let the breath be the bridge between the two. So tune into the heart, feel that peace within. Feel that inner stillness. And let's take a moment to thank yourself for being here today, for choosing to be here to honor, to take care of your body, to take care of your heart, your mind, your soul. And let's just let those arms out, shake it out, yes. Take an elbow in each hand. Once again, feet a little bit wider. And let's just take those arms side to side. Good. So as people who do my class know, I always say movement equals life. Yes. Movement sends the signal to the cells. You're choosing life today. Yes. And let's take those arms all the way around. In a big swirl. Feel the stretch, not just in the shoulders, but maybe in your abdomen. Remember, the more aware we are of our body, reverse the direction, big circles. The more prepared we are for whatever can come our way. If we're walking on the sidewalk and we happen to trip, we're more apt to catch ourselves. When we have body awareness, okay? We can feel our body through space. We are connected. Shake out those arms. Now, I argue, hands on the hips, I argue that most people are disconnected from their body from the neck down pretty much most of the time, okay? If that resonates with you, resembles you, raise your hand. Yeah, because we're all here in our head. This is where we live most of the time, and our little body is just doing what it's doing for us, going through the motions, doing what it needs to do. It came here to serve you, to walk you through this life. Reverse those hips. And so often we just neglect it. We take for granted what a miracle it is and that it works for us. Right? Good. And then let's just relax. Stand tall. Turn to the side. Use a chair or a wall to balance if you need to. And then let's open up those hips. Big hip swings. But imagine if you were working somewhere in an office or whatever, and you're working hard, and you know what you're doing, because you want to better the company or you want to do a good job. But if you never got acknowledged, how does that feel? Nobody wants to go through life feeling acknowledged. All of us need to be seen, to be validated. And the same goes for your body. If your body feels that you don't care about it, at some point it just goes, okay, then why am I here? It sounds kind of harsh, but it's true. Just put your shoes in your body's shoes, right? Good. Let's go ahead and swing other leg. My point is, we need to love, honor, acknowledge this amazing body that we've been given. We only get one. And the most challenging relationship of our entire life is the one we have with ourselves and our body. How many of you agree? Right? Good. Doesn't that feel good on the hips? Swinging those hips? Yes. Bring joy to my eyes and tell me everything's gonna be alright. Good. And rest. Take those feet wide. How we feeling out there, team? Thumbs up? Never been better? Alright, good to hear. Feet toward the screen. Hands on those hips. Lead with your heart. Push the hips back. And just hold it here. Feel that stretch in the back of those legs. Yes. Breathe deep and slow through the nose. Inhale through that nose. Deep into the lungs. Deep into the heart. Deep into the belly. See if you can become aware of where you're tight, where you can lengthen, where you can bring that breath to open up that connective tissue and stretch and lengthen a little bit more. Breathing through the nose, deep into the lungs, is what's called diaphragmatic breathing. Signals to the nervous system that you can relax, rest, and digest, as opposed to being in the stress response, fight or flight, which is where we are most of the time. If we're listening to the news, if we're out in the world, perceiving that to be our reality. Hands on the knee, on the thighs, drop that left shoulder down. Now, I'm not saying that the world out there isn't a reality, but we have a tendency to blow it up and make it bigger in our world, in our personal world, than it needs to be, than it's healthy. Let's drop that right shoulder down. Feel that stretch. Again, listen to your body, tune in, say hello. Say hello, little body, I love you. Thank you for doing everything that you do for me. Good, and then let's take our hands, if you can, to the floor. Bring those feet out a little bit wider if you can. And let's just drop our head down. Resting your hands on the floor. Breathing deep and slow. Close your eyes. Tune in. Feel. Feel this amazing moment that we are given. All our strength, all our courage. And then slowly come on up. Let's come down onto our knees. Yes. How we doing out there, team? A-okay? We're going to do some cat and cow. So hands and knees. We're going to inhale, tailbone up, looking up. And then exhale, tailbone down, round out your back, shin to the chest. Pull the navel in. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, round it out. Moving that spine slowly and effortlessly. Just rounding it out. Let your breath pace the movement. Inhaling through the nose. Exhaling through the nose or the mouth. Notice how your body feels as you move through that moment. That movement. that tension in the muscle tissue. We hold tension because we have tension, stress, and worry in our minds. When we allow ourselves to be present and breathe deeply, we find peace. This is where peace lies, right in the present. Let's go ahead and do some hip circles. Rotate those hips around in a circle. Big circles. Feel how good it feels to feel your body. To tune in, to say hello. And trust me, like a little kid who gets attention, who knows his parents' eyes are on them and they're so proud, your body, or the cells of your body act the same way when you pay attention to it. Go ahead and rotate the other direction. The cells of your body goes, oh my gosh, he or she's seeing me. Okay. Yes. And we experience joy. And joy is the highest vibration there is. Joy and gratitude heals on the deepest of levels. All right, we're gonna kind of roll our spine up and we're gonna take one leg. It doesn't matter which one, just one leg forward because we're gonna do both. Okay, big step forward. Keep your back tall, shoulders, hips square. And we're just gonna drop into that hip, stretching our hip flexors. Hip flexors are right in that hip joint, okay? Those hip flexors get really tight when we are sitting in a chair, sitting a lot, okay? But we're stretching the opposite one, okay, right now. So you should feel that in the opposite leg, on the leg that's on the ground, as you lean forward, you drop into that, you feel the stretch in the hip flexor. Make sure that front foot is far enough in front. Good. So the knee is over the heel, not over the toes. Yes. And again, for those of you who might be watching on Facebook, welcome. This is what we do every Friday morning. On Mondays, we do movement, mindfulness, and meditation on Zoom. And on Wednesdays, we do strength and balance. You want to tune in. I just do this live on Facebook on Fridays, but if you want to join in on Zoom, please do. All right. So now we're going to come straight up, straighten that front leg, bring the toes back. You're going to feel a stretch in the calf, right? Ooh, if you want a little bit more of a stretch in the calf and the hamstrings, sit down on those hips. You can even reach your hand towards your toes. Remember, do what feels right to your body. And maybe if your knees are a problem, you want to put a pillow under your knee. Keep the back lengthened, feel that stretch, breathe deep and slow. Now, we don't want to feel any sharp shooting pains. That's our body's sign that we're stretching too much. But we do want to feel that edge where we are a little bit out of the comfort zone. So whether we're talking about our physical body stretching out of the comfort zone a little bit or just our mind stretching out of the comfort zone, guess what? Out of the comfort zone is where the magic happens. Let's go ahead, come back. Staying in the comfort zone, nothing changes. So if we want to change, if we want to grow, switch legs. Other leg forward, big step forward, shoulders, hips, right in line. Drop deep into that hip flexor. Okay, smiles on those faces. So, we want to grow. We want more from our life, more from our body. We need to challenge ourselves a little bit. We need to step out of that comfort zone. Not to the point of pain, although it may be uncomfortable, but that's how we grow. That's how we invite more of the abundance of the universe in. It's by opening those spiritual doors. Say, I'm ready. I'm ready to grow. I'm ready for more. Good. Feel that stretch and breathe deep and slow. Feel your body just say, ah. Good. And then let's come back out. Fantastic job, everybody. How are we doing? Let's come to a seated position. Okay. Again, if you need a pillow, you could sit on a pillow. Legs crossed. Let's just take our hands to our knees. Our back is tall. Our heart is forward. Shoulders relaxed. Just close your eyes for a moment. Bow your head down. And just feel the length in your spine. And breathe as deep and slow as you can through the nose, down deep into the lungs, deep into the heart space, even deeper into the belly. Feel the belly expand as you breathe in. As you exhale, draw the navel towards your spine. Feel your abdominals contract. So the biggest tool we have to relieve stress in the moment is our breath. And guess what? It's free. All you have to do is just tune in. Breathe deep and slow. Now let's take our left ear towards our left shoulder. Left hand assist. Take your right hand, palm toward the floor. Really get that length through the right side, through the neck, through the shoulder, down the arm. Keeping those eyes closed so you tune in and connect with your amazing body, that miracle that you've been given by the divine. Good. And then we're just going to angle our head toward the opposite knee. So look, your gaze goes to the opposite knee, but keep your eyes closed and then take your left hand behind your head. Pull it down, bring it down toward the knee a little bit more. Take your right arm for a little bit more stretch behind your back. Keep the back tall, the heart is open and forward. And of course, smiles on our faces. No place we'd rather be, right? I just love stretching. I just love the peace that it brings to me. Good. Come back up to center. How do we do? Let's do the other side. Right ear toward the right shoulder. Left hand palm down toward the floor. Feel that stretch through the left side of your neck, your shoulders. Now, where do we carry a lot of our tension? We carry it in our neck and our shoulders, right? I'm always aware, when we get aware with our body, tune in, I always know when I'm stressed or tense because my shoulders are basically up in my ears. That's my body's cue of, Lisa, we need to breathe and chill for a moment. So let's just lengthen here. And then we're gonna turn our gaze toward the opposite knee. Take your right hand, gently press on the back of your head. Now take your left arm behind you. Get a little bit more of a stretch. I'll never forget many years ago when I was an exercise physiologist at the Pritikin Longevity Center here in Santa Monica. And for those of you who don't know, Pritikin was a residential program for people that came from all over the world. They'd stay there 2 weeks to a month at a time. Usually they had heart disease or diabetes, or sometimes they came for prevention purposes. Come on up. Had exercise classes, meditation, got the Pritikin diet, all of that. Okay, we're gonna do some spinal flexion. Heart forward, arch the back. Exhale, round it out. Inhale forward. Exhale, round it out. And I loved working at Pritikin because you could see the miracle of the body within 2 weeks' time just by changing people's diets to more plant-based diets, getting exercise, meditation every day. 80% of the people would get off their medications. Diabetics would get off their insulin shots. people get off their cholesterol and blood pressure medication. You know, as we get older, we think that medications are just a part of it. And I'm going to say a big fat no to that, okay? No. This is what we've been taught to believe. Your body responds. It is a miracle. It wants to be in balance. If we give it the love and the attention, and yes, people might say, well, Lisa, you got cancer and you've been working on it. Yep. And I'm going to say that was a direct result of stress that I carried in my life, grief. I had a lot of change, life changes in a short period of time. And I didn't realize it. Let's go ahead and rotate our navel around. Imagine you have a spoon in your abdomen and you're stirring the pelvic bowl. Shoulders relax. So stress is a killer. How we think, how we see, and if we're in a constant state of stress and tension, our body is operating in that fight or flight mode. And over time, it breaks down our body. Hence why this is so important, what we're doing right now. Let's go ahead and reverse the direction. Taking time to tune in, to be present in this moment, to find the peace, to give your body that break, that breather, that is its natural state of being. Being in stress is not its natural state of being. But in our society, in our world, we've come to believe that it is. Good. Now let's just do some infinity signs with that navel. Just imagine. Again, you can close your eyes to imagine that infinity as you get that spine flowing. Now, at first, if you're not used to doing this movement, it's going to feel very awkward and choppy. And that's just because you haven't developed the neural pathways from your brain to your muscles. But once we do anything consistently and frequently, your brain and your body start to communicate and go, oh, this is how this moves. How are dancers so graceful? How are athletes so graceful? Because they're tuned in. Their mind, their body are connected. They're flowing. Good. Hands on those knees, back is tall. Take that left hand behind you, right hand on the opposite knee, and rotate your torso around in a circle. Feel that stretch, breathe deep and slow. Feel that stretch through the ribcage. Now, as I was saying what I was going to tell you about Pritikin, and then I went off on all of this, but all of that's important. Go ahead and reverse to the other side. Back is tall, rotate around your spine. Is that one woman who came to Pritikin, she was from Eastern Europe. She had a very thick Eastern European accent. And she taught Tai Chi. I had never done Tai Chi. I was probably 27, 28. So I asked her if she could teach me some Tai Chi. Perfect. All right, team, we're going to come onto our backs. How we doing? Thumbs up. Good to hear it. Come onto your backs. And hug those knees into the chest, and let's just gently rock side to side. Give yourself a little back massage. Anyway, so when we first started the very first lesson of Tai Chi, she stood in front of me and she towered over me. She was probably like 5'11", and I'm all 5'2½", 5'3" on a good day. And she puts her hands on my shoulders and she looks straight in the eye and says, take your left leg onto the ground, by the way. Hug that right knee in. And then with your left hand, bring that leg across to the left side. Right arm extends, turn your right head over your shoulder. Keep your shoulder blades flat. Little torso twist. Feel a stretch into the glute. Anyway, she looks me right in the eye and puts her hands on my shoulders and she says to me, drop your energy, darling. scared the heck out of me. And then she smiled. Apparently my shoulders were in my ears. And she wanted me to drop my energy. Good, bring your leg back up to center. Take that leg out onto the ground. Hug the left knee in. With your right hand, bring that leg across your body to the right side. Left, your arm extends. Turn your head over that left shoulder. Keep your shoulder blades flat. Torso twist. Clearly, I never forgot. Drop your energy, darling. And to be honest, whenever I feel, notice that my ears are in my, not my ears, my shoulders are in my ears. It's my body's signal to drop your energy, darling. Meaning drop into my heart, drop into the moment, drop into my breathing. And remember that this is the only moment that we have. And unless you're being chased by a saber-toothed tiger, you are safe in this moment. Hug the knees in one more time. Big stretch. And then let's go ahead, extend both legs out. Reach your arms over your head. Big stretch. Eyes closed. Really reach through the fingertips. Reach through the toes. Breathe deep into the belly. So throughout our whole stretch class, we are moving into a place of relaxation, just with our breath, with our awareness, being present in the moment. Good, bring those arms down. Let's just take this moment here with our arms down, palms up or palms down, whatever feels right to you. And just allow yourself to feel the earth beneath you. Feel your body being totally supported by the earth. And the earth is inviting us to let go. It's saying, let me hold you. Let me carry you in this moment. So whatever you have been worried about, thinking about, thinking you need to control or manage, remember that most of that is in our head. The stress we create in our lives is based on how we choose to see what is happening. I heard a quote once that said, stress is what happens when we are not in acceptance of what is. And again, unless we are in a true life-threatening situation, our body is not meant to be in the stress response. If an animal is chased, it's in the stress response. If it's fighting for its life, it's in the stress response. But if it survives, it goes back to grazing and it drops right back into the relaxation response, its natural state of being. That animal does not sit and ruminate on what could have happened, because what's in the past is in the past. This is where we are now. I will never forget years ago, 2015 actually, when my little miss was struggling a little bit with her health. And there was a moment when I thought it was for sure time for her to go. And I called the vet thinking that he was going to put her down. And he said, no, she's not ready. Long story short, 2 weeks later, she's just walking through the pasture as though nothing had ever happened. And I remember I just kept ruminating on that moment when she was in so much pain and discomfort. And I kept thinking, how can she be here now? And I remember her looking at me and I heard her say to me, why are you still back there? That's 2 weeks ago. I'm here now. This is what's happening now. Let that go. My dear little miss, my greatest teacher. I feel her right now. And for those of our loved ones who have crossed over, they didn't go anywhere. They're still here, just in a different form. And they want to stay connected with you. And in this moment, we are totally supported. We are relaxed. We are free. Allow the earth, allow life to completely support you and hold you. You are safe. Breathe deep and slow through your nose, deep into the lungs. Feel the heart and chest rise deep into the belly. And let's just take a moment and let's just bring our awareness to our toes and our fingers. And I want you to squeeze your toes, squeeze your hands into fists. And I want you to bring that tension up your calves, your hamstrings, your quads, into your glutes, into your forearms, your biceps, your shoulders. Shrug your shoulders towards your ears. Squeeze the muscles in your face and just hold it there. Bring the tension. Feel it. I want you to feel the difference. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Exaggerate it. Tight, tight, tight squeeze. Take a deep breath in. And exhale, release. Just let your body totally relax into the earth. Open the fingers, relax the feet. Shoulders drop in. The skin on your face almost melts off your face. And let's just allow ourselves a moment of silence and inner peace. As you feel your breath flowing effortlessly in and out of your body. Thank you. giving yourself the gift of peace through your presence. Allowing yourself to have this moment, breathing in it as fully as you can. Let's go ahead and start to wiggle our fingers and wiggle our toes. As we breathe energy and we breathe light into our body, all the way down to our toes, to our fingertips, to the top of our head. Let's take our hands and our feet, the soles of our feet, rub them together, feel that connection. Hug the knees in, and let's rock and roll up and down the spine. Come to a seated position, or if you're at home, you can stay just on your floor. Take our hands to our heart prayer position. Let's tune in and thank ourselves for making this a priority of our day. Thank each other for joining in as we all feel the energy of each other. And most importantly, thanking our amazing body for what it does for us every single day. Feel the peace. Recognize this is our truest state of being, and let's take this energy into the world today and make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. When we heal our heart, we heal the world. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining me for Stretch and Relax. I hope you enjoyed it. And that concludes our class. So if any of you have any comments, I'm going to just check Facebook real quickly just to see if there's anything that anybody wants to say. Or good morning. Hey, Lisa. Hey. Oh, excellent, Shirley and Carrie. Oh my gosh, excellent. You're welcome, Carrie. So wonderful to have you, Shirley. Woohoo! And of course, Rita, she's here on Zoom. So I appreciate you all. Thank you for being here. If this is a donation-based class, if you feel called to donate, please do. I appreciate it. And if you can't, that's totally fine. Just keep giving to the world in whatever way you can today, okay? What goes around comes around. Thank you so much, everybody. And for those of you on Facebook, I appreciate you being here. And hopefully I will see you next time. All right. Let me just stop Facebook. Bye, everybody. Okay. And I'm going to stop the recording here. Bye, everyone.